Hey, my name is Mia, and I just want to share a little bit of my story. So about 4 years ago, my husband and I, we got married at 34 and 35, which I know in Christian years is kind of like 85, but that's how it went. So about 2 years into marriage, we thought, you know, we want to start trying to have kids. We'd always wanted kids. We'd kind of even dreamed up what that would look like. And I had been having a few little health problems and I wasn't quite sure what they were. So I'd gone to doctors here in America for about a year and a half, and no one could really figure out what the issue was. And I was home for Christmas in Australia, and I walked into a doctor and I said, look, these are the issues that I'm having. And he said, oh, well, let's just do a scan. And they did a scan, and half an hour later, they'd kind of finished, and I ended up going home and they said, come back and get the results tomorrow. And that night I actually had a dream that I was 20 weeks pregnant with twins, and one was bigger and one was smaller. And I remember in the dream just putting my hand on my stomach and saying, is everything okay? Is everything okay? And I remember the doctor in the dream saying to me, everything is okay. You don't have anything to worry about. And I had a real peace about that. Well, the next morning, I woke up and I went into the doctor and got the results, and they said, you know, we're really sorry, but your womb has grown to 20 weeks pregnant, and there's two masses in there. One is bigger, one is smaller, and they're tumors. And I straight away had to go back to that dream and remember that the doctor had said there's nothing wrong. And I knew in that moment that the doctor wasn't just an ordinary doctor, it was Jesus, the great physician. And so I had this like peace that everything was gonna be okay, but I still had to walk out dealing with like what, you know, the reality of what we were navigating, which was that I had two massive tumors in my uterus. So fast forward like a month or two later, you know, I was booked in to have an operation, and I thought that I was going to be able to have this small operation, but as it turned out, I ended up being booked in and having to have an operation that is essentially a C-section to cut these tumors out. And they ended up cutting the tumors out, cutting into my womb, and even cutting like a little piece of my womb out and having to piece the whole thing back together. And I remember waking up from that surgery, and my husband just looked at me with tears in his eyes and he said, love, I'm so sorry, but they've taken one of your ovaries as well. Which, you know, as a 37-year-old at the time, it's not something you really want to hear. But I remember looking up at him and saying, that's okay, we will just call the other one Hero Ovary and it can be the hero of the story. And, you know, I think we all have like moments that we have an opportunity to come into agreement with what's being spoken over us, or just speaking something different and confessing something in faith, confessing life over a situation that doesn't look promising. And, you know, right in that moment, I don't know if it was like the anesthesia or it was me, but, you know, being able to confess like it's going to be okay and go back to like even that dream that God had given me, it's just so important in like keeping your hope up, because, you know, we had resolved in and of ourselves like that without hope there really would be a barrenness in me. So fast forward a year later, you know, we started trying to have kids, and you know, every month we would convince ourselves this is it, you know, and we stayed full of faith every month, even though the reality was that it wasn't happening. And we got referred to a bunch of fertility specialists, which kind of irritated me because I refused to come into agreement with the idea that I had a fertility problem. And, you know, the power of our agreement really is everything. You know, you can agree with a diagnosis that's being spoken over you, and that may be your reality, or you can come into agreement with the promises of God over your life. And it's why it's so important to get a promise of God every time you're walking through something and navigating something. So for us, our promise was that God had said to us, I will take your story from being a beautiful story to a miracle story. So we had this absolute foundation we could stand on, that every diagnosis we got, every bad report we got, our confession was, but God is writing a miracle story. So a year later, I went in for a scan, and they found that those tumors had come back, and I ended up having to go in for the surgery again. And I remember believing for my healing, believing that God would evaporate those tumors all the way up until like them having to actually cut me open again. And, you know, it's just not the way that it went, but I still had to go back to that original promise, like that God was doing a miracle. So during that, the next 6 months, you know, we kept seeing my doctor and, you know, having to go see this fertility specialist. And, you know, they ended up getting to a place with us where they said, look, you're out of options. It's just not going to happen for you. And I remember looking at the doctor and respectfully saying, you know, I understand that medically this is what you're seeing. I understand that you have a lot of experience, but like my experience with God is completely different to your experience medically. So respectfully, I'm not out of options with God. And I got up and walked out and I said, I will call you when I'm pregnant. Well, you know, a couple of weeks after that, we were riding with the Red Rocks team. And, you know, I love, you know, not every story has like, you know, sorry, not every song has like a story that's crazy and amazing. You know, sometimes it's just like coming into a room and just confessing something. But with this song, Miracle in Me, I had actually had a dream the night before that we'd written a song the next day called Miracle in Me. And Corey came into the session and he said, I had a dream. And he spoke out this lyric, which is a lyric that's now in the song. And we wrote that song on August 30th. And at that point, you know, we still had this diagnosis of it's not going to happen for you. But there's something powerful about saying, you know, this is what I've received in the natural, but in faith, Jesus is my healer, he's my great physician, and so all I have to do is keep reaching for his hem. And I remember like being in the room and even like the faith in the room of just beginning to confess what was true instead of what was reality. It began to just shift some things in the room. And it's one thing to thank Jesus and confess what's true when it has happened. It's quite another to speak it into the atmosphere and call it out in faith and speak that which is still unseen as though it is seen. And I'm so grateful for this song. I'm so grateful for the power of a testimony, not just like one testimony, but like that this song would be testimony upon testimony upon testimony, that people would begin to make this song the banner over their life and say, you know, it is not by my own works. It is not by anything that I've done or anything that I can do, but it is because of Jesus Christ that I can declare that there is a miracle living inside me, that there is a miracle on the way, that there is a miracle within my reach. Yes, I might have received the diagnosis of cancer, but there is power in the blood. Yes, I might have received like a bad mental health report, but there is power in the blood. Yes, I might have received a report that it's not going to happen for me in a bunch of different areas, but Jesus, but the cross, but the blood. You know, I think being able to hold on to that and refuse to take no for an answer, that is the real miracle, that you will not let go of what the Lord has said, of what the Lord has promised, and that you refuse to give in to disappointment, refuse to give in to despair, and refuse to like take a second-rate option. So the amazing part about this story is, you know, we wrote this song before, you know, for me, before I'd even received a miracle, right when I was sitting in the middle of it's not going to happen. Well, 2 weeks later, I found out I was pregnant. And it was quite the joy of my heart to be able to ring the fertility specialist and let her know. And I think that's good. It's a great thing to be able to announce to the world that says it's impossible. It's a great thing to be able to call and say, but God. And, you know, if you're looking for evidence of what God is doing, you'll find it. If you're looking for evidence of what he's not doing, you'll find that as well. And when I look back at this story and I look back at even the way that things have unfolded, you know, it is no coincidence to me that we wrote this song before having the evidence of a miracle. And it's also no coincidence to me that I am actually due on the day that this song comes out. So I pray that it would be a great blessing to you. I pray that it would stir your faith and that whatever you're believing for, where the answer for you has been, you are out of options, that you would be able to declare over yourself, because of Christ, there is a miracle in me.